On your right side, you can see there are 5 9s. So 9999 minus this number, resulting number, 85677. Write it in the next one. So the total number will give you the multiplication of these two. Okay? 85678 minus 1 is 85677. Then 99999 minus this result, 85677. Write it in the other part. So the total numbers is the result. Okay? So isn't it easy now? After knowing the technique? So math is like this. After knowing the strategy, it will be easy for you to answer. That's why it's very important to know the strategy to answer, especially the SAT questions. Okay, before all this, SAT math is not a difficult one, but it is tricky one. Okay, so for the tricky exam, you will work harder or you will work smarter? Smarter, right? To work smarter, what do you need? You need these kind of strategies, right? Okay, so learn strategies so that you are going to get a good score at maths. Okay, so now I'm going to cover, like, you know already there is some changes happened in new SAT math section as well. So what are the change happened? Just we'll go in a brief. Okay, so as Marilee told, we have a course workbook. In that we have updated all the new topics which they have given for the new SAT. That's a new syllabus we have updated. So in the course workbook, basically it's a glimpses of Manyavi Princeton review, RSAT, that is a revised SAT course workbook. So first two classes of math, we are going to cover these strategies, because to answer SAT math question, which are very tricky, you need strategies. So first class, we are going to cover these global techniques. Global techniques are nothing but the good habits which you have to develop in math. That is going to cover. And in the next class, we are going to cover plugging in beta. These are the strategies which you have to use for the new SAT, so which we are covering in first two classes. Okay? So which these techniques we used to use before also, still these are useful. So if these are still useful, means for the new SAT, it will be super useful. Okay, so that's why first two classes, we are covering all these strategies so that you are going to crack these kind of tricky questions. Okay, then fundamentals. So fundamentals is not just math vocabulary, it's algebra. So new SAT math is more of algebra, 90% algebra question you are going to get. So that is converting English into math. So there will be lengthy wordy questions where you need to convert each English statement into math terms, so that you should know each and every English term and what is the math equivalent for that. So that is going to cover in the next class. So apart from this, heart of algebra. So sometimes algebra is unavoidable, for example in these kind of question. So if you look at this question, they have given an equation, that is A is equal to 3 minus 2 into root A. The question is, which of the following is the extraneous solution for the equation above? So anyone know here what is extraneous solution means? We know how to solve for A, but the question is not asking for A value here, it's asking for extraneous solution for A. Yeah. Anyone know what is extraneous solution?
Suitable.
Sorry? Okay, any other answer? Sorry?
Which could be solved.
Best solution. Okay, any other answers? Which will satisfy the equation? Okay, so extraneous solution means the value which doesn't satisfy the equation. Okay, when you solve this question, you are going to get two values for A. In that, which number is not going to satisfy the equation, that is extraneous solution. Okay, like this, new terms are introduced in a new SAT, so which we have already covered in our course workbook. Okay, so that there will be no surprise when you have taken your new SAT. And again, charts and data are there. So with compared to ACT science, we purposely added some history and physics question in charts and data chapter, because in the new SAT, history and science is a subscourse. So to get a practice, we have added those questions as well in the charts and data. And as usual, arithmetic, playing with the numbers, that will be there. And algebra, as I told you, so more of algebra will be there. Okay. So one sample question for charts and data. Look at this question. Usually charts and data question, they will give a chart first and you need to analyze the chart, then predict the answer or find out the answer. But here in this case, if you observe, they have explained a situation over there. Okay, there is a content. You need to understand the content and identify which chart is suitable to those that situation. Okay, so it's in the other way. Reading the content and identifying the charts. It's again a new type of charts and data question which they have introduced newly in the new SAT, and we have that in our course workbook. Next, we know in the old SAT there was no advanced math section, but in the new SAT they have included this advanced math. So advanced math is nothing but functions and graphs question, that is transformation of function, odd function, even function, and you have additional math topics like trigonometry. Trigonometry means it is not the advanced part, basic trigonometric ratios they have included, like trigonometric ratio, sine, cos and tan, not the advanced part. So with that you have 3D geometry, that is solid geometry and plane geometry question. These are the additional topics which they have included and we have in our course workbook as well. Apart from this, there are two types of question they have included in math. One is extended thinking question. So extended thinking means you have to extend your thinking to answer those kind of question. It usually comes in pair of grading question with the common information. Those two questions will have a common information. By reading that, you need to solve those two questions. That we call it as extended thinking questions. And how to identify this extended thinking question? So these boundary line will be there for extended thinking. The content will come within these boundary line and we call that as an extended thinking question. And finally, ETS has decided to have an oddball math question. So this is a new type of question they have introduced. So this we call it as meaning of constant and or variable in context. It means, usually algebra question means we used to read the question based on the condition, we used to form an equation, right? But it is not like that. Look at that. They have already given the algebraic equation. X by 3 the whole square plus x by 5 the whole square is equal to 1 by 3. So the question is asking over here is, what is the meaning of x by 5 whole square in the question? Means the question of this type will give you the equation and they will take a piece of question and they will ask you what is the meaning of this. So you need to analyze the question and answer what exactly it is. Okay, so this is again a new type of question that ETS has introduced in a new SAT. Okay, so last but not least, I want to ask you one more simple math question, okay, before ending this session. So one simple question you have. So you got 10 seconds to answer this. It's a simple question, I know. I don't want to make you disappoint. So it's a simple question, answer me. You got 10 seconds. Yes.
C.
C64.
B.
B for Bangalore. 8. 11.32.
11.
A. B. B for Bangalore.
A.
A.
B.
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 A.
Okay, how many of you got A? Raise your hand. Okay, how many of you got B? Okay, how many of you got C? And how many of you say it is D? Why? Okay, you tell me why it is 11.132.
311, you use Pythagoras theorem and find it.
Okay, so AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD, which is 8. So if you draw the diagonal AC, you are going to get a right triangle. So you are finding, you are applying the Pythagoras theorem to find out the hypotenuse, which is AC. So how much you are going to get? 8 root 2, correct? Which is 11.32. Okay, so why B? Some of you choose B, right? Why B? Just a guess. Okay, so the right answer for this question is D, cannot be determined. He told the answer, not completely. Why, tell me why it is cannot be determined?
Because it is not mentioned that it is square or nothing.
Very good. Why it is 8 root 2? Because you have considered this as a square. Who said it is square?